The universe seems to go on forever. It's big, really big. But how big exactly? Does it all end somewhere, a place beyond which there simply exists nothing but sheer emptiness? Emptiness of space, time, existence, or anything we can think of. No quantum fields, no fluctuations, simply the nothing. Or is the universe infinitely big? Today, I would like to present my case for an infinite universe. Why it seems problematic, but kinda isn't actually. This video is gonna be really different, and I expect it'll be real fun delving deeper into it. Let's start. So, how big is the universe? Well, if you simply search on the internet, it'll get you a number about 93 billion light years in diameter. And the thing is that, it's not even a lie. The universe is really this big. With an asterisk, it is the observable universe, which is 93 billion light years long, not the entire universe. And even the idea of the universe starting out being really small and then expanding after the Big Bang, it's just talking about the observable universe, not the entire universe. And then it might be that there were countless other Big Bang-like events that created their own observable universes. Since if the universe was infinite, it would have been infinite always. And we expect with good reasons that even if the universe isn't infinite for some reason, then also it would be much, much bigger than the observable universe. Even though we haven't seen it. Observable universe, also known as the known universe, is just a part of the universe which we can see. Since light travels at a finite speed, there are parts of the universe from which light hasn't yet reached us, and so we can't see it. It's unobservable. Then how big is the entire universe? Well, to answer simply would be to say we don't know. And since there's a limit to how far we can see, we may never be able to know how big the entire universe really is. But that shouldn't stop us from wondering what lies at the edge of space, or if it has an edge or not. And therefore, a slightly complicated way to answer this is to say, we've got ideas about the size of the universe, though we don't have a number yet, if you consider infinity not a number. Frankly speaking, there are only two options, either the universe is infinite or finite, which is obvious but still a big question. So how can we come up with the size of the entire universe with only being able to observe a tiny part of it? One way would be to use the geometry of the universe. See how the universe is curved in the parts we can see, and extrapolate it to the parts we cannot see. And here we've got three options, though these are also kind of obvious, so forgive me. First, the universe can be negatively curved, which means a geometry in which parallel lines would eventually diverge, something like the shape of a saddle. Or it can be positively curved, like that of the Earth. But third, it can be flat, which means no curvature. The crucial thing here is that only one of the three geometries describe a finite universe, which is with the positive curvature. On the other two, the universe would go on indefinitely. But this is not completely true. If, for example, our universe isn't the only universe, I mean, if there's still something outside of the universe, like some kind of extra-dimensional space, then it won't actually answer our original question. The point of the question was to know the size of the entirety of existence, a place beyond which there's just nothing. But the existence of such an extra-dimensional space would only extend the question, but won't actually answer it. So what do the observations say? What is the geometry of the universe? Well, with the amount of information we have, with being stuck to only being able to observe the known universe, the geometry of the universe looks pretty flat, with some uncertainty that hovers around zero curvature. So does that mean the universe is infinite? Sort of. Like, this isn't in any way the end of story, because we can never be sure of the geometry of the entire universe with only being able to observe a tiny part of it. Like, our Earth looks pretty flat if you were to observe it from the surface, but it is only when we have information about a much larger region do we see that the Earth is actually a sphere and has a positive curvature. The universe, in the same way, can have a curvature with a tiny part of it looking pretty flat. Now, coming back to the question, is the universe infinite or finite? We don't know, and may never know. However, for me, this question is much more about how we should think about the universe and not much about what it would actually turn out to be. And personally for me, a finite universe is much more problematic than an infinite universe. Not like the infinite universe isn't problematic. It is, in some sense. But both of these ideas are problematic in vastly different ways. To start, I'm just going to clarify that I'll be using the word universe to mean the collection of everything that exists, if there are multiple universes, and bunching them into the definition of the universe. Philosophy ahead. The thing that gets me about the finite universe is that it would mark an end to space and time somewhere, or the absence of any place at all. Sure, a finite universe could be closed, like a sphere or a donut, and that way we may never have to encounter such a sharp edge to nothing, but it would still be there. And how would it be that the universe is surrounded by complete emptiness? Emptiness of space, time, and anything we can think of. And what would that even mean, to be surrounded by nothing? Even thinking about it makes no sense, because nothing here is not just about any material stuff. It would actually mean the complete absence of even a place where anything could exist. If the universe is finite, then all that exists is that region which marks our universe. There isn't anything outside. There is no outside. And that gives me an existential crisis. I think I'm getting too far with all of this. I don't know if I can make you feel what I'm trying to say. The point is that as much as you want the universe to be finite, these questions bother me. And I'm probably biased. I want a universe that never ends because the opposite isn't as satisfying. But isn't an infinite universe also problematic, even more in some sense than the finite universe? Sure, but the thing is that the problem with the infinite universe is the same problem we have whenever or anywhere we encounter infinities. It's not just a problem for the universe. Infinite series, singularities, infinite sums, all have problems built into them as infinities. I'm sure there isn't anything that has infinities in it and isn't problematic. But an even nicer reason why I find an infinite universe much more satisfying is because ultimately, the most stable condition would have been to have simply nothing everywhere. And honestly, why anything even exists is a big question. And so, if something can exist in a place where nothing should have existed, why wouldn't something exist everywhere? If the universe exists somewhere, implies the universe can exist somewhere. And if it can exist somewhere, it should be able to exist everywhere. This idea takes away any kind of specialness that we might feel, and that makes me feel satisfied. Another cool reason an infinite universe is a nice idea has to do with the fact that it kind of avoids all of the problems of the finite universe by replacing it with one big problem. The only problem in the infinite universe is that how can the universe, or anything in particular, be infinite? And that's all. Since by definition you cannot quite reach infinity, you'll never have to encounter any of the other problems raised in the finite universe idea. Which means the infinite universe kind of avoids all of those problems. It's not like those problems don't exist, but you don't ever encounter them. So in some sense, they do. But the problems still exist. How can the universe be infinite? A significant portion of this video was based on how I think about the entire matter. And it's not like I'm perfectly comfortable with the idea of the infinite universe. However, I am inclined to it. And my views can turn real quick. So if any time any such events take place that shift my views upside down, don't be surprised. And that's all I think I have for now. I hope you enjoyed this video. I would like to hear your thoughts, and who knows if your perspective might change how I think about all of this.